We can buy the Hunter Chief Emblem, key to the gate to the Grand Cathedral's Round Plaza. Fuck. This is actually really, really important lore. All right, the Hunter Chief Emblem, a cloth emblem that belonged to the captain of the Church Hunters long ago. It opens the main gate that leads to the Great Cathedral. That's where we need to go. The main gut is shut tight on Knights of the Hunt and can only be opened from the other side with this emblem. In other words, the captain's return and this emblem determined the end of the hunt. So, the hunt. The hunt starts from the church. The hunters come out of the church, and the night's not over until the captain returns with this emblem. But that's 10,000 blood echoes. We can't afford that right now anyway, even if we wanted it. Let's try on our new... Oh, I have to be here. My bad. Let's take about our hood. Dude! I mean, not bad, right? Fashion soul. Oh, dude!
Not bad. Not bad.
Conviction. Dude, Bloody Blade is gonna get a fucking hard on for all these like edgy like outfits and shit. What's it look like with the hood? Not bad. This game has a system called Rally, all right? And what Rally does is after we take damage, we can continue to slice at the enemy and it'll regain health for us. And if we read this stuff, just check it out. So it says, when hunters are burning beasts, they appear intoxicated by the euphoria of purification. So we're talking about being intoxicated or the euphoria. And then it says here, in Yharnam, they produce more blood than alcohol as the former is more intoxicating. And so what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to let this guy, he's going to hit me and I'm going to show you the rally. So he's going to hit me and then I'm going to get our health back. So boom. So basically, we've almost fully healed now. And what I believe is the intoxicating form or the rally feature is as we fight, you see that we get covered in blood. And so I think after we get hit, if we keep slicing at them, their blood becomes what coats us. And that's why we're able to heal. So it's a way of injecting ourselves with blood, but instead of using a blood vial, it's literally just going into the wounds that we have opened up during the course of battle. So the blood that we spill on ourselves gives us health back. Look at this guy. Look how much more transformed he is. Look how closely he resembles those werewolves that were being crucified. Yet, he still will... Stupid idiot!
Hello!
Oh, hey, another one. Yet, he still uses like a torch and a sword, just like the guys up top, you know? Why? Oh, fuck, I almost fell. It's just interesting to see the similarities, yet differences. He has the same elongated limbs as the counterparts that we see up top. So as we go deeper into the bottom pits of Yharnam, it's almost like the beast scourge is taking hold. Hello? Nakey Jakey. Oh fuck.
The fuck you said to me, you little shit!
Yeah, I do. yeet! Oh, there you are.
Come here, bitch.
The range on the whip is incredible.
Don't hurt me.
That's fine, we're gonna get our health back.
I'm an innocent man. Please.
Oh, a throw. What the fuck? Why did that mouse drop a throwing knife? Are you guys protecting anything back here? Ah! Well, we got some health back, so that's good.
Hello?
Oh, fuck! Oh my gosh!
Is it me you're looking for?
Come here.
I can see it in your...
Oh, I guess I really do remember how to fight this.
I can see it in your smile.
Yay! See ya, bitch. Ooh! Hunter set. Ah, I missed it! Ew, dude, we're in the sewers. Let's heal up. What the fuck is that? Whoa! Remind me of some of the zombies from the old arcade game, House of the Dead. They just remind me of them. I'll pick it. Oh, he's alive! That guy right there is alive. I didn't realize that. Use the whip, baby! Whip it good! Yeah, we can keep such good distance. Like, that's so good. But if we get closer, does it do more damage? I've never experimented with the threaded things. I want to know. So we do 34 back here. Let's see what happens. So if we get closer, it's still 34. So we might as well. Oh, for distance. Let's heal up, please. All right. Sorry, I had to do some learning right there. More bullets, thank God. Oh, shit. Oh my god, we have new clothes. Hunter hat, the hunter garb, the gloves, and the trousers. And look, dude, like, this isn't just a generic body. This is the hunter himself. Like, yeah, it didn't take the clothes off of his body, but that's the hunter's body that we found. So let's learn about what type of hunter he is. Hunter hat. One of the standard articles of a hunter's attire, fashioned at the workshop. A fine piece of attire that provides stable defenses to anyone facing Yharnam's beastly threats. Recognizable by its withered feathers, this cap is fashioned after one of the old hunters. I keep hearing the words hunter thrown around, right? But when we look at it this way, it might be backwards for you guys. I'm sorry, I don't know how to flip that, but maybe it will be right side up. We know that there's church hunters. We now know that there's old hunters. And now we know, well, we're wearing the Yharnam Hunter's cap. So think about it as a groups of hunters. So each faction, if you will, has their own set of hunters. And so if we were to compile data of what we know so far, the church hunters, let's read the Kirkhammer. A trick weapon typically used by the healing church hunters. The church takes a heavy-handed, merciless stance towards the plague of beasts, an irony not lost upon the wielders of this most symbolic weapon. Dude, I wish I could hold it because it is a giant fucking sledgehammer. It smashes skulls, it destroys bones, it crushes brains, dude. This is one of the loudest weapons in the game, okay? So, under church, I'm gonna put fucking brutal, alright? Brutal. I'm going to put loud. Think about this. Threaded cane, one of the trick weapons of the workshop, commonly used by hunters on their duties. This weapon is all about class. It even uses the word conceal. Concealing the weapon inside the cane. Why would you want to conceal it? Oh, maybe because we don't want people to know that we're hunters. Oh, the set we just picked up called the Old Hunters set? Talks about hunting under the cover of darkness. So, under old, I'm gonna put stealth or quiet. we're gonna find more stuff that we'll put under old hunters as well. And then Yharnam hunters. Unfortunately, there's only a few things we have when it comes to Yharnam hunters. And they don't always call them Yharnam hunters. Stuff we'll learn further on will basically be like, oh yeah, that belongs in that category. But just trust me when I say this, please. If we go to the Yharnam hunters cap, Ludwig, the first hunter of the Healing Church, once recruited Yharnamites to serve as hunters. This hunter's attire was made for new recruits, but not nearly, it had excellent straightforward defense, but not nearly enough to allow an ordinary man to stand a real chance against the beasts. So what I would say about Yharnam hunters, honestly, is throwaways. Because we know the Healing Church already has their own set of hunters. However, at one point, Ludwig goes, holy fuck, this is getting out of hand. We need more recruits. And who does he turn to? He turns to the people that were fighting, like the people, I guess a different group of people, but think about it, the Yharnamites. He calls them in. Now, do they get as much advanced tech or weapons or defenses as his actual group of church hunters? No, dude, they get the fucking throwaway shit, all right? And we know that because it says it right there. So I'm going to say throwaways or weak. Throwaways. So keep that in mind. Just because we hear the word hunter does not mean that each group doesn't have, or there's not more than a few types of hunters. So we'll keep that diagram with us. And I might try to make one that's better as well. So the old hunters. Hunter garb. One of the article of clothing of the hunter attire fashioned in the workshop. Garamond's at the workshop. A fine piece of hunter attire that provides stable defense to anyone facing Yharnam's beastly threat. Allows one to stalk beasts unannounced by cover of night. Let's put this set on. Let's check it out. I don't even look at defenses in this game. I literally just fucking do fashion. Oh my god, dude. How can we not rock this? Excuse me? How can we not rock this? Timmy, show me that conviction. Fashion lord. Fuck off, crow. Fuck off, crow. Fuck off! Okay, let's see if we can get a backstab visceral. Through the anus, baby. Through the anus. Valor through the anus. All right. Let's talk. Goosebumps, dude.
Who are you? I don't know your voice, but I know that smell. Are you a hunter? And that is where you look for my mom. Daddy never came back from the hunt, and she went to find him. But now she's gone too. I'm all alone and scared.
Hello? I don't know your voice, says the little girl, but I know that smell. Either all hunters have a certain smell, using incense to ward off beasts. We might actually keep incense on us. Or hunters themselves are covered in so much blood that the iron inside, that makes up the blood coats our skin. And that's what she smells. She did not recognize us. She can't even see us. But the stench of our hunter, basically, the stench of a hunter, she recognized. She said, will you help me find my mom? She went looking for daddy. Daddy went off the hunt, but he's never come back. We will find your mother.
Really? My mum wears a red-jeweled brooch.
Okay.
It's so big and beautiful, you won't miss it. Oh, I mustn't forget. If you find my mum, give her this music box.
Music box? Tiny music box.
It plays one of Daddy's favourite songs. And when Daddy forgets us, we play it for him so he remembers. Mum's so silly running off without it.
Oh my God. It plays one of Daddy's favorite songs. We play it for him every time he forgets us. Mom's so silly to run off without it.
My mom wears a red jeweled brooch. It's so big and beautiful. You won't miss it. Oh, and if you find her, give her this music box. Please, I know you can do it.
We'll find your mom. We will. We'll find your mom. Good guy Timmy with the bow. All right, let's... Oops, I forgot it's a lever, not pushing. Let's... Oh, and then, have you noticed? I sat here in silence. Have you noticed that music stopped? Tiny music box. A small music box received from a young Yarnum girl. It plays a song shared by her mother and father. Inside the lid is a scrap. Oh, excuse me. Inside the lid is a small scrap of paper, perhaps an old message. Two names can be made out, however faintly: Viola and Gascoigne. Let's use the item. It's the song. She was sitting here playing that music box, waiting for Dad's return, hoping he would walk by and hear the music. Y'all, what's up with that? The music box? Like, what's up with the music box? I don't understand the question. I want to make sure I answer it for you.
My mom wears a red jeweled brooch. It's so big and beautiful. You won't miss it. Oh, and if you find her, please.
Alrighty, let's carry on. We're gonna go back down, actually. You'll see. Well, my goal is to make all revelations happen when you would organically go, "What the fuck?" And if you were playing this blind, but also explain as we've been doing. That way, you guys can fucking experience the story on a level that I wish I. You're going to experience this story in a way that took me 4 years to research. That way, all your guys' brain blasts go, "Holy fuck!"
Wretched outsider. Trying to fool me to open this door. Heaven's the depths of depravity.
Helps you understand it for when it happens. Yeah.
Wretched outsider.
Alrighty. Skull of an enlightened madman. Use it to gain insight. Oh, that's the currency we were talking about. Remember when we said, something of significance or major importance to the story happens, we gain insight and the world changes? Okay, wait. So, madman's knowledge. Let's read about this. Skull of a madman touched by the wisdom of the great ones. Use it to gain insight. Making contact with eldritch wisdom is a blessing, for even if it drives one mad, it allows one to serve a grander purpose for prosperity's sake. Wait, what the fuck? So we just have this guy's skull in our pocket and we can use it to get insight? I think that's pretty fucking cool. Huh. I don't know if we need to use it yet, but that's wild, dude. We just found a fucking skull. Oh. Hey! Get away from that door! Woo! Ah!
Any safe places?
I don't think you can go there. I know of the Hunter's Dream. Can you teleport like we can? Can you traverse the upside down? Your neighbor's doggies last night? Did you whip them as well? Did you get a chain and whip them around? God damn it, Fruity, you're so evil. Fresh and Fruity says, damn, you whipped them dogs like I whipped my neighbor's dog last night. Fruity, I don't think you're a good fit for our community if you're really whipping dogs. I'm gonna get in so much trouble by her. Do we know of any safe place? Yeah, can you go to the Hunter's Dream?
I've heard I have. Shutting up indoors isn't always enough. Well, if you want to get off your asses, you wouldn't be in this mess.
Jesus Christ, she's pissed.
You're obligated to help me, you hear?
Okay, entitled much?
So what would it be? Are you gonna tell me you're not?
Oh! No. No.
Yeah, I should have known.
Yeah.
Yeah, good for nothing. No respect for the elderly is what that is. That little good you outsiders do. Go on. Admit it. You think we're all mad, don't you? Well, go and stop it.
Well, excuse me. Fuck off, lady. Do you know of any safe places? Well, if you had to get off your asses. All right, so that's the old deer. My favorite NPC of the game. Jesus Christ. That is Fresh and Fruity. Let's be honest. Let's be honest. That's Fresh and Fruity. Holy shit. Let me have a good look at you.
Oh, a hunter, are you? And an outsider. Sorry. What a mess you've been caught up in. And tonight of all nights. Here, to welcome the new hunter.
Ooh. You killed Eileen? What the fuck, Timmy? Oh, okay, you're lying. Kappa, all right. A bold hunter's mark. A new hunter, are you? On a night like this.
Prepare yourself for the worst. There are no humans left. They're all flesh-hungry beasts now.
I'm sorry, what about the bitch that we just saw with dog and... Is she a flesh-hungry beast?
Still lingering about. What's wrong? A hunter unnerved by a few beasts.
God damn it.
No matter. Without fear in our hearts, we're a little different from the beasts themselves.
Okay. And we got our favorite gesture. At least my favorite gesture. Shake off cape. Let's equip that right now. Shake off the cape. And we will put conviction on the right. Okay, so let's see it. Fuck yeah, dude. We beat the shit out of someone. Nothing. Alrighty, so she says, with no fear in your heart, you're no different than the beasts themselves. So this is Eileen the crow. And we'll learn more about her.
What are you still doing here? Enough trembling in your boots. A hunter must hunt.
Alrighty. She is a hunter of hunters. We will learn more about that as we progress. But we wanted to make sure we got her her gesture. And then we got a bold hunter's mark. Awaken anew without losing blood echoes. It's basically a homeward bone. However, it is the same. Devin! What up, Devin? Nice to meet you, dude. Thanks for the follow, dude. I really appreciate it. Devin guy. Breakfast Club, can we please give Devin a warm welcome? So it's basically a homeward bone, dangling upside down rune etched in the mind of a hunter. The image upon this parchment allows one to envision the rune with clarity. It allows a hunter to awaken again without losing blood echoes, a trick that seems nearly too good to be true. So if we remember, the hunter's mark The one that I said, okay, remember when we talked about closing your eyes? This is how I interpret it. When you close your eyes and then you cover your, and you're really, really in that darkness. And sometimes you can see shapes in the lines. I see colors if I squint really hard, things like that. So if you imagine those shapes, it says here, a dangling upside down rune etched in one's mind. I believe it as you focus. It says by focusing one's thought on this rune, a hunter loses all blood echoes, but awakens afresh. So it's just like using the dark sign in Dark Souls. But the lore reason behind it is you have this symbol etched in your mind. I envision the hunter basically just really focusing on it. They warp away. However, with what Eileen just gave us, the bold hunter's mark, it's written down on parchment. So we can focus on that instead of our mind, which would consume all of our currency or blood echoes. Goodbye, Eileen. Workshop Sancton Hunter. All right, now we have a name to associate with that middle sect of hunters. Let's learn about them. Badge crafted long ago at the workshop. Attests to one prowess as a hunter of beasts. While the workshop is gone and no group recognizes this meaningless badge except the messengers in the bath who understand its profundity. I don't know that fucking word. Certain things can only be entrusted with a hunter in possession of this badge, or so they believe. Holy shit. The workshop is gone and no group recognizes this meaningless badge. Okay, so we know they were stealthy. We know that Garmin. Oh, I should write Garmin's name with them. And we know they're now profundity, otherwise way of saying profound. Thank you. Workshop. So now we know they are the workshop hunters. Garmin. Interesting. So we'll have to turn that in, or excuse me, since just like we talked about how it's kind of like Pokemon, we're going to be able to unlock some new items in the messenger bath. So we'll have to see what we can get. Are you guys ready? If Z Timmy wasn't the player character, this is who he would be. He's so lucky he's a... Ah! Not the crow. All right, if Z Timmy wasn't the player character, this is literally lore. Okay, that's Z. Oh yeah, Fresh and Fruity. We made Z Timmy, and this is him. But if Z Timmy wasn't the player character, this is him in the lore world. I know I've seen the movie, babe, but my god, little kid, you are getting me. Oh, fuck. Bro. Babe. You're good. Oh, shit. You did good, pig. You did good. All right. And this is what I do to Z Timmy if he's a pig. Thank you. A little pork chop, baby. Ah! One must pay respects. One must always pay respect to some Canadian bacon. Oh god! Bang, 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 bang! Z Timmy! Sticking with the Syrup Squad for 10 months, dude! 10 months, brother! You know what? I think all the syrup is gonna be drank in your honor. My god, dude! Aim Pepe. Thank you, brother. Fuck, we're out of syrup. I gotta buy more syrup tomorrow, dude. That's it. Say goodnight to the skinny sticks.
fish.
I did it for the new people. I did it for them to go, what the fuck? But I sound like that blowfish.
That's it. That's it. There it goes. The skinny sticks
has been conquered. Holy fuck. And clipped. Think, can we get, are we going to be cocky and fuck it up? Ow! I could parry them, but I'm trying to save the bullets. All right, I should definitely parry them. Hold it, hold it, hold it. Ah! The pain! I got clipped, dude. I wasn't expecting that. Cracker Barrel. Oh, dodge! Oh, I thought that was going to finish him, but that's fine. Okay, here we go. Here we go. Dude, fuck yes. Here we go, baby. Oops, I guess not. Sorry, chicken. Hold on. Jesus Christ, what the fuck is going on?
Beasts all over the shop. You'll be one of them, sooner or later.
To the roar!
Dude! Dude, Father Gascoigne. Let's see. This is the father. Shit. How are we parrying this guy again?
Do a barrel roll.
Ow.
This is the girl's dad.
Something, a-hole.
Let's play the music box. Hey. There he goes. Stumbled, staggered by the box.
Do a barrel roll.
What? You missed that one. Try another.
Nice.
Do a barrel roll.
It's been like 4 years.
Try another.
Fuck me right in the ass.
What's that smell? The sweet blood. Oh, it seems to me it's enough to make a man sick.
I don't know. I love the fucking dialogue in the front. Hey! I don't know how to. Come on, dude! Ah! Uh-oh.
You missed that one. Try another.
Okay, I'm not used to these timings. Come on. Jesus Christ.
I am owning you, you fat, bald, fatty, fat, fat.
Who said that?
Uh-oh, here we go. Oh, baby. What the
now
fuck?
Now you fucked up. Now you fucked up. Now you fucked up. You have fucked up now. Woo! Now you fucked
up. Oh, we're upstairs. We got, I didn't know we were
up.
Here.
Now you fucked up. Now you fucked up.
Papa G, baby.
Get back here.
Heal. What? 3 bullets in a dream. Fuck.
Your ass gon' die, man.
Oh, track,
say goodnight,
dude.
Motherfucker.
No! Papa G gave the smackdown. Small music box received from a young Yharnam girl. Plays a song shared by her mother and father. Inside the lid is a small scrap of paper, perhaps an old message. 2 names can be made out. Viola and Gascoigne. So if you remember, her dialogue said,
it plays one of Daddy's favorite songs.
And when Daddy forgets us, we play it for him so he remembers. Mom's so silly for being off without it.
So, one can theorize that Gascoigne, so close to beasthood, would come back from hunts, and he would be just discombobulated or distraught. And so they'd play that song, and it would bring him back to reality and remind him who his family is. The thing is, at this point, he's consumed by the blood. And you can see that once we reach a certain phase, he transforms fully into Beast Gascoigne. I don't know if his name changes, but I'm just saying he changes into beasthood. But we can use the tiny music box, and it staggers him for 2 seconds or so during the fight to give it a little bit of an opening. So it's actually a really, really valuable tool. But we don't want to spam it, because then it loses its effect. Or it makes him change into beast form faster. I can't remember. All right, fuck off. Oh, God. 3 shots. Do it again. Should I say the most PC elitist bullshit in my entire life? You fucking dick. Say it. I'm just not used to this 30 frames per second. Oh god, our echoes. Let's go grab that. Fuck me! Chicken, you know it, brother. Oh. Nice one, Gascoigne. I really am not respecting this fight. Like, I just remember when I was playing this with Rennick, like, I just remember, like, knowing the timing so perfectly a few years ago, where I would just parry his every goddamn axe swing. But I have to, like, just admit, like, nah, bro, you don't know that shit no more. You might remember the story, but I don't know that. Fence broken out, and we drop to a roof. And here it is. It's really sad.